Welcome back to This Bites For You. So you may have just gotten yourself a Sapphire Radeon Nitro, RX 6800, or maybe you got lucky and got yourself an XT. After you watched my video on installing the card, you realized I can't change the lighting. I want it to match my system. Or maybe you don't have ARGB in your system, but you want to customize the video card. But you can't do that right now. Actually, you can. It just changed today. Sapphire released Trix 8.0. And now with Trix 8.0, not only can you change the RGB lighting like I showed you 2 days ago on the beta, but you can also optimize your game so that it plays better without having to overclock your game. You can check all of the system hardware, your BIOS, the GPU speed, the fan speed. Not only can you check the fan speed, but you can also check to see if the fan is failing, and then you can test each and every fan on the card, which it has three, but you can check each and every fan with the fan software to see if it's working as it should, or if it's starting to die and you need to worry. In this video, I'm going to show you each and every step to get you guys going. So stay tuned to the very end. And then we're also going to have a discussion on the software and everything in the system. So let's check it out real quick. All right. So here we have Sapphire Trix 8.0, the latest and greatest version running. We can see right off on the dashboard, all the system vitals, the GPU clock, memory clock, GPU temperature, GPU load, GPU voltage, then along with a host of other detailed specifications. All right. And that's just the dashboard, and we can save the BIOS, save the report, and then change between the different vBIOSes. Coming over here to hardware monitor, we can see again, all the system vitals, what the GPU clock is running at, memory clock, GPU temperature, all this information here, and scroll down, you get a little bit more. This comes important when you're doing overclocking and benchmarking, so you can see just what everything is running at. Now, talking about overclocking, Trix also has Trix Boost. Now, this is a Sapphire only technology, which is amazing since not all of us know how to overclock, and overclocking isn't just a pop, you're overclocked. It takes a lot of time, a lot of patience, a lot of time mainly to get the perfect overclock. Plus you need a 100% stable system in order for you to actually find out, hey, is this overclock stable? It is? Cool. Let me overclock it more. If your system's unstable, it may crash and you think it's the overclock, but it's not really. So what Sapphire Trix Boost allows you to do, it allows you to get in between those resolutions and optimize your game without losing any or much detail in your game. It's pretty awesome. I'm not going to show you that right now. I'm going to show you that in another video, but I just wanted to go over that real quick. All right, so aside from Trix Boost, we have the fan health check. I have a lot of you asking me all the time, hey, my fan didn't start up. Is it dead? And there is no real way to know aside from sticking your finger in there, either getting it chopped off or, you know, some other kind of utility. But fan health check allows you to test your fans to see if there's one that's kind of dying or one that's almost dead or, you know, totally perfect. Let me show you real quick how it works. All right, so we can see right now, since the system isn't really doing anything, I can touch the fans, they're not spinning. Oh my God, they're dead, right? No, they're not dead. The fans usually kick in at around 60 degrees, but then how are we gonna test them without actually playing a game, right? So with fan health check, we can just click right over here, and I'm going to lower the microphone so that you can hear just how loud it gets. All right, I have it real close. So you're going to get a lot of the wind coming out right over here, but that's okay, just to give you an idea of what you can expect. This will crank up the fans to 100%, but don't worry, chances are pretty slim that's actually going to happen during gameplay, unless you have horrible thermals in your system. So I'm gonna click it right now, and you can see on the screen. So it's testing this fan right now. All three of the fans actually, but it's checking the RPMs on this one first. Now it just moved on to this one. Now it just moved on to this guy.
Right. So fan health is okay.
So that just showed you if your fans are going bad or they're still great, like it is right now. That way, you know, if you're having issues, you check this out. Man, this fan doesn't work. Just give Sapphire a call or open up a support case. They'll help you out getting that fixed. So it's some great diagnostic utility. But anyway, let's go over to my favorite part of this video, Nitro Glow. All right, so with Nitro Glow, here we're able to change all of this lighting here, here, up on top here. And then there's actually some lighting here, which is kind of cool the way they added it. So let me show you real quick. So we'll start off with, right now it's on custom color, which allows you to change to any color you want. And then if you want to go down as deep as, you know, playing with these values, you can change it to whatever you want to achieve your exact color, which is pretty awesome. And then over here, there's a little slider so you can adjust the brightness or just completely turn it off. We'll keep it 100%. Then over here, we have runway, which is kind of cool. I like the way that that works. I think it's pretty sexy. Steps before color change, you can notice right now, it's cycling between a few different colors. Now we can have it change a lot quicker. And we can have that speed go up. The Knight Rider speed there. Pretty cool. Let's bump it up 100%. I think that's so cool. Then we can have single color. And you can change the color change delay. Drop it all the way down. And like with all of them, you can adjust the brightness. Then we have my favorite, rainbow. To me, it's just very soothing and relaxing. And then we can just bump it up. And then we have cereal. I love the way that they added lighting right over here. Okay, then we go to audio visualization. I like this one a lot too. So we come over here. All right, so with this software, or with this setting, I should say, we can come into any video we like.
In this video, we're going to be doing an unboxing and a brief overview of the Sapphire Nitro Radeon RX 6800 gaming graphics card. These videos to me are incredibly important because the last...
So you see how that goes with that. So let me show you the YouTube audio library. All right, so here, let's go for this guy. Go ahead and fast forward that one a little bit. So that's pretty cool the way that one works. We can jump over here to custom color, which is the mode that we started the video in. And then if you're boring, you could just turn it off. Nah, just kidding. Not everybody likes it, but you know, you could turn it off. And then this is another exciting one that a lot of people have asked for, external source. So you can see right now, it matches the memory and these other fans right over here, and perfectly, right? Now, if I were to open up the Asus Armory Crate and come over here to Aura Effects, we can, right now it's at CPU temperature. My CPU's at 25 degrees, just 24 degrees, 23 degrees. I have the Liquid Freezer 2280 from Arctic. It's amazing. So let's go ahead, go over to static. Now my whole system changes. And then from static, I could change to whatever color I want, and everything, the video card, the memory, the fans, and anything else I had connected to the motherboard or an RGB splitter, it would turn to that color. Breathing, that's another relaxing one to me. We can go for strobing. Change the speed if you want. We'll go to color cycle. Just goes through every single color. And I'm going to focus a little bit later on this logo over here. I think it's pretty nice. Then we'll come over to rainbow. Starry Night. This one can get a little bit crazy. Then of course you're not stuck to those colors. You can switch it to whatever you want. You can also address the different RGB colors as well. Go to music. And just like before, that's pretty awesome. Then we'll go over to smart. This is what it was originally, that it goes by the CPU temperature. Then we go over to adaptive color. This is going to go by the color of whatever you decide, a picture or anything along those lines, the different areas of that picture. Dark, and well, that just turns everything off. And now you're seeing the camera lighting. Pretty boring to me, but whatever. Then you can get a little bit more creative with the Aura Creator and design your own RGB lighting and everything. So it's pretty cool. Again, my favorite here, and we'll just go a little bit crazy with it, or a little more relaxing. So let me show you a little bit more on the coloring of the card, the different areas real quick. All right, and I went ahead and turned off the lighting on the camera so that you can get a better experience here. So along the side of the card, we have this strip right over here. And this is what I was mentioning, the lighting on the PCIe connections. Pretty nice the way that that stands out. It also lights up these holes over here. And there's that logo. Really nice the way that they implemented the lighting on that logo. Then we can see back over here. So if you notice this cable, now of course I turned off the lighting, and I'll get back to that cable in a second. And then we have the Sapphire logo right over here. And this Radeon is not lit, but so you can see a little bit more on the card. Really is beautiful. So now all of you that wanted to change the lighting on your card, that wanted to check the fans to make sure they were working properly, to wanted to see your hardware specifications, and also wanted to get more control of your games without overclocking, because it can take a long time and it is annoying, you can do that now with Sapphire Trix 8.0, just released today. Pretty awesome. Now, it didn't come out when the card came out. They wanted to get the card out to you guys quickly. The software can take a few days, but they wanted to make sure that it worked across the gamut. So pretty awesome that they took that time. I released a video just 2 or 3 days ago on the beta, only showing you Nitro Glow. I'm glad the final version came out and I can show you how to use it. I'm gonna show you a little bit later on how to use Trix Boost, but I wanted to make sure I get this video out to you guys quickly. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. As I mentioned before, in the description below, I have a list for those ARGB cables because it is awesome. You can now control it externally. You don't need to use Trix if you don't want to, as long as you have ARGB headers and some fan control or some lighting control software from Asus, MSI, Gigabyte, sorry, ASRock, and anybody else. So pretty awesome that they give you that ability. Now it just doesn't match its own. It can match the entire system. And the fact that I included the cable down below, you guys can find it nice and easy. Again, I bought 2 of those cables just to make it easy for you guys to make sure that cable's long enough to go across the entire system if it needed to. So as always, let me know what you guys think down below. If you like this video, go ahead, if you want to, buy me a cup of coffee. I'll always appreciate that. Help to support, keep the channel growing so that I can get bigger and better, better equipment, better everything, so that I can provide you guys with bigger and better videos. All right, guys, this is Iggy with This Bites For You. Again, showing you some Trix 8.0. Iggy out. See you guys.